Hello everybody and welcome to another episode of Train Simulator 2014. We're going to pop quickly in. This is Jack Wall's Let's Play. My kind of name is Joker Man as well. I've got 3 medals and I'm at a driver level of 4 on my way to 5. I've completed 5 of the 6 scenarios that I've played, but if you remember, if you watched episodes 6 and 7, you will see the disaster unfold for that. And I think there's a big ugly X. There it is. Yes, this Frostfall was a bit of a disaster, and I haven't really recovered yet from that. So we're going to pop in here to an ice cool morning. And it plays on the word ICE, the Intercity Express 2. I did actually have a crash here. So I'm going to pop back in and see if it comes up with resume. Okay, well, here we are. You can see the pantograph going up. It tells us, good morning, you're connecting passengers at Hauptbahnhof Gleis 7. And it looks like we're 3 kilometers away from that at the moment. So let's get our brake off, let's get our forward motion in, and let's start making some forward movement. We're heading to Sealy. Or seal. The controls on here are rather different, and I don't know where the light switch is yet. Or indeed if there is a light switch. Is there a light switch anywhere? Well, I'm gonna have to look around here sometime soon. We'll keep the speed relatively gentle for the time being here. Don't want to overspeed. That's my throttle, that's my speed pre-select, that's my pantograph, that's my acknowledge, and my start. Nothing here seems to work. What's that? That's my override, my free acknowledge. Well, I don't know. We're going to speed up a little bit more here. We have to get there by 56. So we are going to give her a little bit of juice. And we have our lights on, so... So you can hear the notes on this kind of do-do-do-do-do as it powers up. It's a pretty kind of cool, it's a pretty cool thing. That's my door switch. I'm still trying to find my way around the cabin here. Headlights. Cabin lights. There we go. Headlights. Oh, okay. That's better, isn't it? We can run it up to 110 here. I'm not going to go near 110. I'm going to go up a little bit towards 65 or 70. And that's going to give me enough room to slow down. That'll be enough. We'll let it run in on that now. We do have an independent brake lever in this train that we do have to manipulate, so unlike the previous videos where the red handle acted as a brake if you brought it down to its position now, on this train we have to apply brake independently, which is what I'm doing at the moment to bring myself into the 60 mark, and from there I'm going to take the brake off and just let it roll. We have a 40 coming up, and I am not slowing down, and I'm getting hosed for speeding. And, I'm getting... Okay, well that's... Seriously. What a start. Am I the only one who's getting kind of confused by, there's a 40 coming up here inside a 60 zone, but the HUD is telling me that it's 40. Am I the only one who thinks that there's a mismatch here? Or am I truly just useless at this game? I honestly genuinely don't know what to trust. I guess I... because in the other train... I don't understand. We're going to start bringing it down to, here's the platform coming up, number 7 is on our left. And our timing is, we're coming on station around about the right time. But we have a little bit to go. So we're just going to run in onto here, just a little bit faster. And we'll start applying brake now at a fairly gentle rate. And that should bring us to a stop with all our carriages in on the platform, which is around about now. I'm still doing 20, so I need to knock it off now fairly aggressively. Which, there I go. Full stop, take it out of motion, open the doors. This is the train. She'd be nice looking. She's a long one as well. Wow. Look at that. Reminds me of a train I was once on in China. Yeah. Well, that's a bit disappointing that I'm minus 242 and I haven't even got out of the station yet. Now we're in express, so we're departing at 9. I've got 3 minutes. This is going to take a little while because the passenger loading progress is going quite slowly, so, but I should be able to leave on time. That's going to give me back some points. And then it's a case of not screwing up, I guess. It's only a 17-minute run. So it's not a big trip. But blasted anyway for the speed. I mean, I'm not intentionally, I'm actually trying not to speed in this game. But the information that I'm getting on this progress bar on the HUD and the warnings coming up didn't line up with what the dial on the top of the HUD is telling me. And I got penalized quite badly again. Huh. At least the windscreen wipers work nice and quietly. Is there a windscreen wiper speed option? That's the sander. What's this button here? Nothing. Pantograph. Start. Anyway. 59. We have another minute before we are out of here. We need to leave within the inside the first minute, basically. This could prove to be 17 minutes of quite a lot of fun. 17 minutes of hell begins momentarily. Okay, 30 seconds to go before we roll over to 9 o'clock. And honestly, I'm going to have to look at the forums a little bit more and try to find out, you know, what the hell is going on. Is this just me, or is it something that... I mean, I'm prepared to believe that it's me first. You got to believe that, because I'm pretty new to all of this. So we get 500 points, which is... I need to go into forward motion. 500 points is not bad. Now move the cab station to the other end of the train and proceed north to Kelly. Oh, go to a stop. Go to stop, go to stop, go to stop. We need to move to the other end to go north, so there we go. Pantograph is up. Power is up. Brake is off, forward motion. And away we go. Okay. Started going in the wrong direction there. Now it's saying 60 here on the HUD just above the 500 amps draw. So I am going to keep it to 60. And we will try to turn on our cab lights again, which is that one. So that'll roll through nicely, maximizing our time. Now there's 110 coming up, and it just doesn't add up always. That 110 needs to move off the progress bar before I'll even consider going anywhere near 110, or even a kilometer above 60. I'm assuming it's kilometers because we are in mainland Europe and they're all kilometers here. Oh, I'm speeding already because I just took my eye off it. Damn, blast it. Give me some brake. Now it's gone, so I can bring it up to 110, but I need to look outside now just in case there are any speed restrictions as we go through here, and there don't appear to be. My lights are all green at the moment for here. So yeah, on the main dials on the console, we're climbing up towards 100. And I don't know what this dial is, but we seem to be doing okay. We'll push to 100% here. Don't see anything telling me that there are speed restrictions at play. Apart from I'm speeding now because I'm... Jesus, I take my eye off it for a minute and she goes mad. 32. I mean, I might lose these 200 points by the time I get to the end of this run. Ah, jeez, man. So we'll just give that a little bit of 14% or so, just to keep her honest. We do have 160 coming up. We do have a clear run going along. And we have another 14 minutes of travel time, approximately. Estimated time of arrival is 19:18, which is a minute late. So I'm pressing the Q key. To keep that thing not going mad. And nice sound in the tunnel there. Little bit more speed. We're on canted rails here, so we're not really being too upset with the speed and our passenger comfort. So nobody's spilling coffee on themselves. We're inside the speed limit. No more speeding, Jack. No more speeding. A little bit of snow going on, but generally it's not too bad. Let's keep that windscreen clean as well. Now the 160 is coming up, which I'm hopeful is going to take back some of my delay. Because I'm a minute and a half out now, and she's whacked up to 160, so... Full power to the engines, and off we go. I need to see this 1825 drop down to 917, preferably 916 if I could get down that far. I've gained a second at the moment. I've just gained 2 seconds, so it feels like it's going to be forever. Arrival at platform 5 in 12 minutes. Is the schedule. So I don't know. We've got a green light here, so we're good to fly through. And, yeah. She'd be nice. We're flying along here lovely. We're up at 56 here now, so I'm just going to bring that down to 10% and we'll try and ease her up towards the 60 a little bit, but we are, now, this Langenhagen Mittelgleis I'm hoping that I can just power through here. Because, you know, there's no speed restrictions that I've seen. That is the lamest. That's really very lame for a horn. I was expecting something with a little bit more. Okay. Hopefully the station master has warned anybody there to stand back from the platform because there's a high-speed train coming through with an Irishman driving it. And he doesn't really know what he's doing, so it's better to not be around him. But that horn is disappointing. I mean, really. Anyway. This is the horse market that we're going through next. And we really haven't made any time up at all. So at the moment we're late. I'm just borderline the speed limit. 30% at the moment seems to be holding me there. 40% actually might be a bit better. That's brought me back up one, so 35. Well, we're kind of maxing out our speed as much as we can. 1.7 to the next traffic light. No signs of speed restrictions on route. Windscreen is clear. This one has a nice fresh wiper blade on there, so... And we're still losing time on our estimated arrival of 1917. We're 1918.33 at the moment, and doesn't look like we're ever going to get back. Possibly lost some of that time moving in the wrong direction from the Hanover station. Every time I hear that little beep, I'm pressing the Q key. This is quite a little bit different from the English trains that I've been driving up till now. Wow. Some action, some activity, and we have it's Sernhagen. A little small stop, and we're going to come rearing through there at 159 kilometers an hour. Must be going uphill a little bit, I guess, or well, maybe not. It's just resistance. It's a pretty big train. Oh, we get to go 200. That's nice. Be nice to do 200 now. But if I do 200 now, it'll tell me that I'm speeding and that I'm very bad. Stand back. Stand back. Stand back from the edge of the platform, or you could get sucked into the train. That wouldn't be very good at all, now would it? We have 23 kilometers to go, and we are about to enter a 200 zone, which will be nice. We've been up there at that speed before with the EMU trains back in good old Blighty. But anyway, 200, go, 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 pulling 500 amps, well, she's kind of a gentle pull, but I suppose there's an engine behind that's sucking down amps from these lines as well, so, really going to have to stick it into top gear to try and control this time. We're losing seconds all the way. Q. Yes, I'm still alive and kicking. Green light on the trail, so that's good. Coming up to Grossberg of Idle. So, another little small station. Seriously, how is that going to warn anybody of anything? We we will push it as close to 200 as I dare, which is probably 202, knowing my skills. Incidentally, we have 202 points to lose. Q again. Click, click. 200, there we are at 200. And we will give it 38% to try and keep that. I took my eye off it again, that's why I slapped the red down so aggressively. I thought, oh no, 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 don't go more than 200. I want to protect my 202 points that I have. Green light's on the track. All good. Slight incline, it looks like, but maybe I'm just thinking that. Definitely the snow is kind of coming in at us a little bit. I'm pushing 500 amps, 65%, and I'm getting no increase in speed. Brakes are all off, forward motion selected. Just got a kilometer back. Looks like I've saved a little bit of time here. Let's kind of get it up to the 200 again. Q, 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 Q. Don't want the emergency brake coming on and ruining my day. 50% power now. Just to kind of hold it in the 199, 198, 199 mark. Green light's on the track, that's good. A kilometer to the next traffic light. We'll give it a little bit more on the power. 13 kilometers to go. A couple of icons here that are different at the moment, so that's me pressing the Q button to knock off that buzzer. So hopefully the train believes that I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing here. We're beginning to gain a little bit of time back. We're 18-18. We might be able to drop back into the 17s at this rate. Which is nice. I am really pushing it to the max though. I'm really on the edge of 200 now. And I'm going to try and get it up to 200. Green light on my side of the trail, so we're pretty good. Just knock that back to 55 now so it doesn't grow so fast. Or maybe 60 is the way to go. Yeah. Don't have any profile here that I can try to work out if we're going up or downhill. I think we're pretty level, judging by the HUD below. 18:10, so we're 10 seconds away from getting back to the 17s. Our arrival time is 17s. We are 8.8 kilometers, and so we're probably going to start dropping back down to 160. I expect to begin to see that sometime appearing. Green light on the rail, so that's all good. I don't think I'm going to expect any danger ahead signals that I need to clear. 5 seconds away from 9:17. No sign of any speed restrictions coming up on the HUD. There's a train coming against us outside. We are running the 200 on the money at 58% power. We're still pulling a full 500 amps though to maintain that. Which is interesting. Isn't it? Here's this first speed restriction coming up, 150. It's 2.5 kilometers away. And we're down into, we've just broken back into the 9:17s. Hit you. We need to start applying brake now. Cause we've got to lose 50 without killing ourselves. So we'll knock that off. 47% brake. Well, we're going to be able to do that fairly comfortably. So there's amps going back into the system. With the minus amps registering there. 58, I'm going to take off the brake now and just let it roll because we're not applying any power, and we need to arrive at the CL5. So there we are at the 50, so we're good on that. Brake is fully off. We're going to keep running now. We're not going to slow down much. But we actually are going to slow down now because we are 2 miles away from Cecile 5. We're not going to necessarily arrive within the 17, I think. But we're just going to bleed off the time a little bit now. Because I'm going to actually start to add a small amount of brake. Because we are 2 kilometers away. 1:33 now. I need to come to a stop here, so I need to drop off a little bit of speed here now. I'm going to add about 25-26% brake. See if I can drop this down under 100 fairly quickly. I've got 1.25 kilometers to go and I'm doing 100. I think there's a need for me to start applying more. Now, what the hell am I going to... there's a red light. But it wasn't on my rail, right? We are applying brake fairly aggressively now. We're at the 70s. We'll take off the forward. She's giving out to me. We're at the 40s, we can just let her run a little bit more onto the track now. And we will be on station now doing 30, so we can bring her to a stop. Fairly gently. Our arrival is 17:35, so that's not too bad. Full brake, stop. Take it out of gear, open up the doors. And there is our arrival. Not too bad. We're not in line with the other train. That engine is further up ahead. But we are on track. And hopefully we'll earn a few points for this. That would bring our experience up a little bit. And give ourselves a little bit of confidence back after the mess from the last one. Done. That was a successful drive. I get 500 points. I arrived at the 17 window, so that's good. Scenario is complete. Well, that brings us up to 2559 experience points. We earned 702 for that, so that's good. Looks like I've unlocked the Hamburg-Hanover short journey completed achievement. But look at that. I get a whole load of speeding to begin with. Which I have to take responsibility for, because who else is going to take responsibility, excuse me. But I am also going to argue that the information being fed back to me on the speed that I should do was somewhat confusing. My timeliness is good most of the time, and then I had some small speeding fines or penalties, but nothing terrible. Although when you add up all of those fours, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 fours is 28. 16 and 12 is another 28, so that's 56. 56 points is, you know, for the little small errors that were down there. Of course, I lost over 200 up here. So that concludes this episode. I have a little bit of a success that we've had, needed that success after episode 6 and 7. We'll go back and hit those again so that I can get it ticked off properly. But for now, hope you enjoyed it and catch you next time.